Okay, Dr. Hastion, let's see what happens when we drop the eggs.
Okay, Doctor,
let's get up on the chair. Do you want to count to three?
Yes, Doctor.
One, two. Let's see what happened.
Yeah.
First, we'll take a look at what happened to Dr. Hastion's egg.
Okay, let me cut open the tape.
I really hope it didn't break.
Me too.
Let's see what happened. Let's take a look.
Whoa!
Look at that, Doctor. Your egg didn't break.
That's awesome.
Good job. High five.
Yay. And now we can eat the popcorn.
I mean, if you really want to.
Go.
Now let's take a look at what happened to my egg. Wow. Look at that, Dr. Isha. My egg didn't break either.
Whoa!
Isn't that amazing?
That's awesome! Looks like both of our contraptions work!
That's amazing. Thank you for helping me, Dr. Hastion.
You're welcome.
So, before Dr. Hastion leaves, we want to tell you something.
Merry Christmas!
Let's say goodbye to Dr. Hastion. Bye-bye, Dr. Hastion, and thank you for helping.
You're welcome. Bye-bye!
This was amazing, but why didn't the eggs not break? Well, you see, it all has to do with potential energy and kinetic energy. But what is potential energy? Potential energy is the energy that an object has when it is held in the air but isn't moving it. So the potential energy is the weight of the object times the height that the object is at. And that is the potential energy. And when we let the egg or the object go, that energy turns into kinetic energy. And kinetic energy is the speed at which the object is falling. But what does that energy have to do with the egg? At the molecular level, there is a certain energy keeping the molecules together. And if more energy is applied to the egg than the standing energy that is keeping it together, the egg will break. So, how do we reduce that energy while the egg is falling? One of the first options is to simply slow down the kinetic energy by using something like a parachute. But for our experiment, we didn't do that. But there is another option, which is what we did. And that option is to extend the impact time of the fall. And we did that by adding material that can absorb that kinetic energy. So what happens when the egg falls inside of the popcorn is that the kinetic energy is carried over to the popcorn, thus reducing the kinetic energy when the egg hits the ground. Isn't that amazing? I want to challenge you at home to make your own egg drop device and see if you can find any other way to stop the egg from breaking. I hope you've learned something interesting today, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again next time.